It's here. It's finally arrived. Yes. Antminer.
C9.
Whoa.
Too close.
Yeah. There you go. Good.
Can you keep a secret? I think this is the first Antminer Z9 in Canada.
Yeah.
So, stay tuned. Yeah. Hold.
All right, there we go. If you didn't know, there's an Antminer Z9 Mini. This is not that one. This is the full size.
Whoa!
I almost bought the Mini though. Almost, it was this close. I actually purchased it on the Bitmain website. But you have to send your wire transfer, your payment to China. I was about to do it, and then they released the full size. Now the full size is supposed to be 4 times faster. Yeah, 4 times faster. Let's find out what it is. Welcome back. If this is your first time here, I'm John Charette, and this whole channel is all about making passive residual income. Today we're talking cryptocurrency miners, the new Antminer Z9 full size. So I was saying, I ordered this thing on July 12th. It didn't come in until September 24th. Now, that being said, they had to build it. They knew that it wouldn't ship until September 1st to the 10th. A little bit of delay, all good. Not a big deal, not surprised. Good, so I received it a couple days ago. Let's unbox it. According to the manual, the first thing you're supposed to do is take the screws off, check the boards, and make sure the heat sinks haven't fallen off. If you turn it on and a heat sink has fallen off, it'll burn. Okay, now that it's apart, spin it right side up and remove the power cables from the boards. And then, now that the board's disconnected, slide it right out. And there it is. You can see there's actually 4 heat sinks. There's the back, and there are 3 of them. So make sure these heat sinks are on nice and tight, and slide it back in. Okay, now that it's unboxed, we make sure that all the boards are good, the heat sinks are attached, everything's okay. If you didn't know, Antminers don't come with power supplies. Now, Antminer will want you to buy their power supply, and I didn't. Their power supply, this runs about 1100 watts. Their power supply is for about 1200 watts. It's great, totally will work. It has 7 connectors, perfectly fine. What I don't like about it is that I like to put all of my miners in battery backups. The battery backup units that I have can only support 900 watts. So I have two of them. So instead, I opted to go to parallelminer.com and buy their Z9 kit that has two 750 watt power supplies with like a connector cable so that I can have them on two of the battery backups. Okay, it comes with two of these boards. Okay, right? One board, two board. A boatload of PCI Express cables. You'll need seven of them to get this guy going. Fancy little cable. This cable is special. It actually attaches the two boards together. The idea is that if one power supply turns off, it turns them both off. That way it doesn't fry the other power supply. Okay, key, it's good. All came with it. And then it comes with two HP 750 watt power supplies. One and two. Okay, first thing, we need to connect these connector boards onto the power supply. Let's connect them together. Now we need to connect all seven. Next, they need power. Now, there's no on-off switch in the Antminer, so as soon as you plug these in, it turns on. Wait to hear the noise. So, that's it. Unboxing, setup. I'm going to move this downstairs into my basement before the wife gets home. I don't know how she'll react to the noise. It is definitely a lot louder than my GPU rig. So, maybe I have a solution for that. Stay tuned, I'll find out what the hash rates are and how it compares to the Mini, and if you can overclock this guy. Thanks for tuning in. We'll be right back.